This video discusses how opening elements are placed into various building element types and the various options available for their placement. An opening is a linear extrusion of a base shape that cuts out its extruded shape from the geometry of another element. Let us take the simplest case of placing an opening into a straight vertical wall. Click on any point on the wall to place an opening. It may be placed in the floor plan viewpoint or in the 3D viewpoint. In 3D, place an opening by clicking on any point of the surface of the wall. After placement, let us select a created opening element in 3D. We can see the outlines of its base shape in its reference plane, plus its extrusion vector, which is perpendicular to its reference plane. The intersection point of its extrusion vector and its reference plane is called its anchor point. Like doors, windows, and skylights, openings do not have their own layer, and they must always be placed into another element. When an opening is placed, a link is established between it and the target element it is placed into. The selected opening's connection grip indicates this link. Openings may be placed into walls, slabs, meshes, and beams. Openings may be created in one of two shapes: rectangular and circular. After a circular opening is placed, we can stretch it at any of its quarter points to achieve an elliptic geometry. Polygonal opening shapes are planned to be released in a later ARCHICAD update. Before placement, we can specify the dimensions of the bounding rectangle of the opening and an anchor point location, which will determine where in the opening's geometry the anchor point is located. Additionally, in the floor plan viewpoint, we can define the anchor point's height values, then place the opening. When placing the opening in 3D, we define the location of the anchor point by specifying a point of the element's surface, and the opening's geometry will be generated relative to the anchor point based on the specified setting. An opening can be placed with one of several possible orientations: with the aligned orientation option, the reference plane of the opening is aligned with the geometry of its target element, and its extrusion vector is perpendicular to the target element. In case of beams and vertical walls, this means that the opening will have a horizontal orientation. In case of slanted walls, the orientation of the opening's extrusion vector will be perpendicular to the slanted wall surface. In case of slabs and meshes, the opening will have a vertical orientation since these element types have a horizontal reference plane. The next two available orientation options are vertical and horizontal. An opening can be placed using any of these three orientation options, so we can place an opening with the vertical orientation into a vertical wall to create a wall niche, or we can place an opening with a horizontal orientation into a slab to create a slab recess. There is a fourth orientation option called custom. This option may not be selected before placing the opening. However, a placed opening element can be freely rotated in 3D using the PET palette. And when it is rotated, its orientation becomes custom. It is also possible to first set the orientation of a placed opening to custom, then rotate it freely in 3D. We can also specify the limits of the 3D cutting body of the opening. three options are available here. The first is infinite, where the opening's cutting body is infinite and has no limits on either end. With the limit one side option, the opening's cutting body is half infinite. In this case, we can define the offset of where the cutting body starts relative to the anchor point. This offset value may be positive or negative. We can also flip the direction of the half-infinite extrusion body to the other side of the opening's reference plane, using the Flip button. With the Limit Both Sides option, the opening's cutting body will be of limited length. In this case, in addition to the offset, we can specify the length of the opening's cutting body. Please watch all other clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the capabilities of ARCHICAD's new opening tool.